Some of the biggest flaws we see in terms of posture with young athletes is head being down, yep, shoulders being forward, and around in the back.
So let's just say you're a left tackle, okay, and you're right here, and I'm an outside linebacker, so get in your stance if you're the tackle, and I'm gonna be here. So if I'm standing up and I'm in a run or just a basic position,
okay,
I'm here. This is a natural 2-point. So I wanna be here. We call this a 9 technique because I'm pretty much splitting his crotch, splitting half a man, but I'm outside. So when you see me in this position, more times than none, I've got force, which
fair
means
enough.
I've got everything outside and I'm setting the edge.
Okay.
So my natural position is I don't want to get too tight in here because then it allows him
gain leverage.
To gain leverage on
trouble.
Me. So I want to give myself enough space knowing that I can get up the field if I'm pass rushing. Mm-hmm. I can get outside, set the edge if it's a run, outside run. I'm still able to react if it's something going down.
Okay.
And I'm also able to get outside and drop into coverage.
It's gotta be a multi-dimensional position.
It is.
Like, you just don't wanna be in a position where you can do only one thing and be a one-trick pony.
No, you don't. And sometimes guys limit themselves by their stance.
Okay.
Like again, if my stance, my base is too wide, now I'm limited. Only thing I can do is get a step forward or I can't react. And I'm gonna be too slow at doing everything. So I wanna be in a comfortable space where I feel athletic, where I can move, I can function. And I don't want to be on my heels. I want to be on the ball of my toes.
Okay.
I want to be on the ball of my feet so I can be able to move, so I can feel like,
kind of like a boxer.
So I can move. So as you mentioned, my shoulders are up. I'm sitting in my glutes.
Okay.
I'm here and I'm comfortable.
Right.
So if I want to put my hand down, it's just like alignment. I'm comfortable, I'm here, and my hands are here.
Talk about the hands again. You see a lot of guys with the hands here. You see a lot of guys with the hands here. You just had your hands in a different place. Why?
Well, for us, for me, and what I teach kids and I teach players in general, your hands are gonna have to be able to strike.
Okay.
Okay? Using your hands as a defensive player is a lost art. The great ones, they use their hands, they're great at it.
Same
Aaron Donalds,
O-line.
Devon
yeah.
Millers,
thing,
all
yeah.
those different guys
mm-hmm.
you mentioned who are really great,
mm-hmm.
they're great with their hands. Especially a guy like me with long arms, LeCharles. An offensive lineman, his job is to eliminate space. He wants me here
yes.
so he can grab me, so he can eliminate me from running around him and doing all that. I have long arms. I'm an outside guy. I want to eliminate space so I can work.
Correct.
My job is to avoid, get around him, get to the ball.
Right.
So if I'm here, my hands are here. If he steps, boom, I'm here.
Right.
So more times than none, these guys are a lot heavier,
mm-hmm.
bigger, and stronger than we are. If I allow him to load and get into me,
be trouble.
It's gonna be trouble.
So
he's gonna win the battle.
If I'm the offensive lineman and your hands are down,
my hands are down.
Say I'm the left tackle, your
yep.
hands are down, I got a clear shot, a clear path to your chest.
And who's gonna win that battle?
I'm probably gonna win that one. So if your hands are now in between your legs, same thing again, I have a clear path to your chest.
And
so if you put the hands up, now we got to fight.
So if we're going full speed, right,
mm-hmm.
and my hands are down, like you mentioned, my hands are going to have to go from here to here, mm-hmm. then shoot.
It's too much action.
You're already into me.
Yeah. So let's build a good stance, stand-up stance with him. What are we trying to coach him to do?
So first of all, get your legs shoulder width, what's comfortable for you. So if that's comfortable here, and then a slight squat. So you could even go here, put your hands in the 3-point, and then just pop up a little bit. And now you're comfortable, and there's your hands. And what's the first thing he did?
Put his hands at the bottom.
Hands at the
yeah.
bottom. So your hands are here. So now your hands are here. So even if you're up a little higher, or you got to just get comfortable with
yeah.
you. I'm 6'5".
Okay.
So I'm not going to be way down here.
You don't, okay, well, why don't you want to be too low, though? Because we hear a lot of coaches say, get low, get low, get low.
It is get low, but you want to get, I'm 6'5". I'm not going to get under a guy who's 6'1", 6'2".
Right, right.
Okay?
I wouldn't know nothing about that, because
right.
I'm about 6'5" myself. So I don't know nothing about that. All right,
well,
go ahead.
You just look at me and him.
Exactly.
Right? If
Fair
he's
enough.
Low, I'm not going to get as low as him.
Correct.
But at some point, he's got to come up to attack.
Okay.
So I want to be comfortable, and I do want to be low. I'm not going to be here because now I have no power in that stance.
You don't want to lose posture.
No.
So you don't want to sacrifice your depth for posture.
No.
You want to be at a position where you can get low enough to maintain proper posture.
Proper posture. I want to be explosive.
Okay.
And I want to be strong in that stance.
Functional.
Exactly to what you're saying, functional.
Got it.
If I'm too low and I'm here, Now I can't move.
You're gonna come up anyway.
I'm gonna come up anyway. I'm gonna come up here to do what I need to do from mm-hmm. here. So now he's in his stance. I think you're a little too wide. Shoulder lift, but get comfortable. So you could be able to turn. Boom, you could turn, you can swivel out of that. You could push forward, right? Right, you could push forward, and then if it's a run block coming, you're gonna be able to get into it and drive, right? Mm-hmm. If the guy blocks down, you're still able to go down,
right?
Squeeze the play, squeeze the mm-hmm. hole, mm-hmm. and if it's an outside play, you're able to pop outside, attack
okay.
his shoulder.
Okay, so what about a down defensive end position? So now I'm in a three-point stance, what's changing?
Well, if I'm in a three-point stance, so now I'm a defensive end, so the one thing you have to understand is, let's just say we're here, mm-hmm. and I'm in a left-handed stance,
okay.
and he's the tackle.
Oh, you're the tackle.
He's the tackle. So I'm gonna be here, and left hand is gonna be down, okay? For me, this is a wrong stance. You see that?
Why is that?
Because my first step now is here,
okay.
with this inside foot.
I got leverage.
You got leverage, because if he's reaching me, mm-hmm. now he's gonna pop out.
Correct.
So I tell the guys, switch your stance. You can put this foot back, but your hands here is gonna be a little bit back. You're gonna be comfortable in your stance, right? I can get up, I can move, but my first stance now is here.
Yeah.
Now is here. This hand and this foot and this leg is always on the string together.
Okay.
It's always on the string. If I'm in a five technique and I'm outside, my job is to not let anything get outside of me. That's my first job.
Okay.
Take care of my business first when it comes to that. Make sure I secure my job. And make sure I'm in the right position and I'm comfortable to be able to do that.
What about the posture in that three-point stance?
Well, the back. Mm-hmm. I heard you talking about the back mm-hmm. a lot. Your back,
you don't want to be bent. You don't want to be bent over here. You want to be up. You want to be comfortable.
Right.
Your head needs to be up. My head is up.
Shoulders pulled back.
No round in the back. No round in the back.
Okay.
Because then it's like a plane taking off, right? You want to be able to come out of that stance and go.
And be violent.
And be violent.
So let's build out a down defensive end type stance with him. How's he gonna go through setting it up?
Well, first of all, get back those legs nice and balanced, okay? Even shoulder width. And then depending on what side you're in, let's just, for instance, say we're just on the same side. This leg is gonna be back a little bit. This hand is gonna be down in the dirt. So now you're comfortable. So now even if I put this up, I'm still comfortable. So you're not too far
forward.
Forward.
Right.
Because now your first step is gonna be where? Here.
Sloppy.
And you're gonna be falling down.
Stumbling, yeah.
So you gotta make sure you're comfortable. So if we're here, let's just say you're a left tackle, right? Put that hand down. Now come off your thigh and get this hand up. Again, remember, why is this hand up? So I can attack. Put this hand back so I can attack. Even if your stance is a little even, mm-hmm. it still allows you to move either way.
Yeah. So those are the key points. Keep the head up, shoulder blades back, and we do not want the round in the back.
You don't want too much weight going forward. Because if you're leaning forward and your balance is off, naturally, like you always mention, like we teach these young men, everything is gonna go forward.
Football,
so now you gotta take that
movement.
Step.
It's a game of movement. If you can move properly, that movement must begin with the proper stance.
And leverage.
right. So if you can move properly, that now allows you to gain leverage
right.
on the opponent, which now puts you in a better position to play the game at a high level.
Right. And a lot of times, you know, when we're coaching and we're teaching these kids, we're so engulfed with the play and what's happening with the play versus how do we need to function and move within the play.
Mm.
Like, I'll take the technique and the fundamentals.
Right.
Before we start talking about X's and O's, because if these kids are not doing it right, if we're not doing it right mm-hmm. as athletes, mm-hmm. we're gonna lose the battle up front. We're gonna lose the battle period
right.
anyway.
Right.